In this screencast, we're going to look at a spreadsheet solution for adiabatic flash of binary liquid. So this is feeding a liquid high pressure, lowering the pressure such that some of this mixture evaporates. And we get two phases, vapor and liquid in equilibrium. The idea, we want to calculate what's the outlet temperature, what fraction of the feed liquid evaporates, and then what are the compositions of the two phases that form. This is a representation of the process. And what we're going to do is put in the parameters into a spreadsheet, and then we're going to use Solver in Excel to calculate the compositions and the fraction of liquid and vapor and the temperature. And so we're using a basis of 1 mole being fed to the system. So let's now go and look at that spreadsheet. So here is a spreadsheet that does the adiabatic flash calculation. And I'll just go through some of the aspects, give you an idea, but it's not possible in a short time to go through all of the equations. The equations were developed in the screencast that set up the problem. And what we do is input here our feed temperature, feed pressure, and the mole fraction of methanol in the feed. It then calculates the mole fraction of ethanol. So these could be changed. Changing the pressure, as long as the pressure is high enough that we have a liquid, it's not going to have an effect on the system because we're not changing the enthalpy significantly for the liquid. And then we have to guess our outlet temperature. So I've guessed 400. The outlet pressure we also input, that's 2 for this problem, but we could certainly have a different pressure. And then we guess the mole fraction in liquid phase for methanol. The program then calculates the mole fraction for ethanol. And then we guess the number of moles of liquid. And then over here, the number of moles of vapor are calculated. This cell is the Antoine equation for ethanol, Antoine equation for methanol. And then the mole fractions that result from mass balance. And of course, this mole fraction is such that the 2 mole fractions add to 1 for the vapor phase. So these are properties, vapor phase plus the saturation pressures. And then what we're going to do is in Solver, change temperature, mole fraction liquid phase, number of moles of liquid to satisfy the energy balance. We want this to be equal to 0. And then this is Raoult's law for ethanol, and this Raoult's law for methanol. We want those to be 0, and we'll use them as a constraint. So if we go to the data solver, and I've already input the values, we call the cell where right now the number is minus this cell right here, minus 11,522. That's what's named energy. We're setting that equal to 0. We're also setting the 2 Raoult's law cells equal to 0. And then we've constrained that the mole fractions are greater than 0. So when we hit Solver, and let's do this so we can see what's happening. When we hit Solve, it says it's found the solution, and indeed, temperature 365 Kelvin. Here's the mole fraction liquid phase of methanol and the number of moles of liquid, and then similar information for mole fraction in the vapor phase and the moles of vapor. And you see all three of these are set equal to 0. I could put them in a different format, and the number, you know, is going to be very small. It's a very good regression. So this is a spreadsheet to solve these adiabatic flash calculations. And there's different ways. Certainly this could be set up. This is just one way that certainly works quite well for getting a solution. We could change this pressure to 4 bar, for example, and go to Solver again, ask it to solve. Again, it solves. Now the temperature 386, different mole fractions, different amounts of liquid.